Hi friends, my name is Sumitra Dudani and I'll be discussing chapter 6, One Understanding That Ends Disappointment. In this portion of the book, Sister Shivani makes us realize that peace and happiness go hand in hand, and the more natural feeling it becomes for us, easier our life would be. By the end of this video, you will become a giver of peace, love and happiness rather than be a seeker. She says that every being carries 5 types of sanskars. The first set of sanskars we get from the family. We are in the vicinity of family members, so their energy automatically influences us. The second set of sanskars comes from my environment, religion, city, school, and friends. We have always heard you will be colored by the company you keep, the environment and the people around you, the energy around you, the belief system around you create sanskars. The third type of sanskars are from our past. When I understand that I am an eternal spiritual being, I just change costumes and my soul journey is through different costumes. There are certain sanskars I have created in my past. Today, I am in this costume coming into action. They are all creating an impression, which is a sanskar. When it is time to leave this body, sanskars don't get erased. They are carried forward into the next birth. Now, some will not believe the past birth logic because we don't understand it. To which she explains, yet, two children can be twins, born under the same zodiac sign too, same date and same place. They may go to the same school, growing in the same environment, but their personalities will be different. Because few years ago, when they were in two different costumes, they were not in the same family, not in the same country, and not in the same environment. We cannot ignore past life sanskars, because they are dominant factors in determining the present. We fail to understand people because we are only seeing them in their present costume. We are unable to see that they are carrying a past. Now suppose you get angry too often and too soon. So you can't say that maybe because I was angry in my past life, so I can't help now but be angry in present as well. This brings us to the fourth sanskar, that is willpower. Every time one says, this is because of you, or I'm getting irritated because of this, I imply that I am not powerful and others can overpower me. Willpower means I have the power to choose, to think, to be, and to do what I want. Every time I use that power, it's willpower. Many times we feel we don't have this willpower, to which she says everyone has the same amount of willpower. It just depends on how much we are using it. We disempower ourselves by not using our willpower. There are people who have took just 2 days to quit their addictions of 30 years or more. We all have certain human qualities. It all depends on our willpower to use it or not. By saying we don't have time for spirituality or we don't have time to meditate, we choose not to use the powers that we have. It's like I have a whole lot of property in my locker, but I refuse to open it and use it. Instead, I go around begging people for love, peace, and happiness. Because I am not using that time to go to my own locker and fetch them from there. Many a times we create one positive thought to empower ourselves and then follow it with several negative thoughts which will disempower us. Once we decide to do something, we just need to create one single thought and start working on it. In addition to this, Sister Shivani also talks about the energy and vibrations that we send to each other, which gets transferred faster than words and is more powerful than the former. Suppose we don't like someone's shirt, but we might just say that, wow, your shirt is so nice. To which she asks, why do we need to say that in the first place? Why do we need to think to please others? And if, even if some circumstances come in which we have to say something which we don't really feel it, we need to check on our thoughts first. We need to see whether our words and thoughts are in harmony and then communicate. But in this process, we are being dishonest and cheating ourselves. There is disharmony between my thoughts, words, and actions. This disharmony flows in other aspects and ultimately reduces our willpower. To activate our willpower, we need to understand our fifth sanskar, that is our original sanskars or nature. Every being is originally pure, affectionate, peaceful, blissful, and powerful. Every being has this nature and we are looking for it outside. Strange, isn't it? Only because we have forgotten that this is our own nature. Spirituality shifts our belief from I want happiness and peace to the truth that I am a peaceful being. I am a blissful being. I am a powerful being. If I understand that I am peace, I am a giver. It ends my seeking for happiness, asking for love. I start sharing peace, love, and happiness with everyone. It automatically flows from me to people around me. No wonder why I wish to listen to BK Shivani so carefully. So, before we jump into the next video, let's say it to ourselves. I am peace. I am love. I am knowledge. I am bliss. Please do comment the same below to manifest the positive energy. Om Shanti.
Hi guys, I hope you must have liked our initiative of 1 book, 1 hour, 1 week. Also, we'd like to take a moment here to thank you guys for all your support and love as we hit our first 200 subscribers. Please like and share this video and do subscribe to our channel to keep yourselves updated for the coming videos. Thank you for associating with us and have a good day.